This is the Falkirk wheel, and it's one of the greatest bits of modern industrial design in the world. On the top of that hill is the Union Canal, and down here is the Forth and Clyde Canal. And the traditional way to get boats between them was a flight of locks, which would take about a day to get through, and besides, they were dismantled here in the 1930s. The solution? The world's only rotating boat lift. Now, boat lifts aren't a new thing. They've been around for centuries. Most of them, like this, have two caissons, which is the technical term for the tubs that the boats sit in. Although, usually, they're next to each other rather than rotating around a central point. And the reason for two is this. To lift 500 tons of water 24 meters up, you need a minimum of 32 kilowatt hours of power. That's about what an average British house uses in 3 days, or an average American house in 1 day. And that's before friction. That's just the potential energy you need to put into the system to raise it up that far. But if you're also having the same weight of water descend at the same rate, at the same time, then you're not adding any potential energy at all. On average, nothing is going up or down. You're just getting a really heavy thing moving and then stopping it again. Because of that, this wheel only needs 1.5 kilowatt hours for one lift, less than a 20th of what it'd need otherwise. There are even some boat lifts in the world powered entirely by gravity, where local conditions and the architecture permit it. You just fill the top one with a bit more water, let it go, and then apply the brakes when you need to. Bit tricky with something that's as fancy as this though. It has to be massively reinforced, and there is an incredible amount of momentum involved. And here's the really clever bit. Remember Archimedes' principle, the Greek bloke with the bathtub? A floating object displaces an amount of water equal to its weight. An object that sinks, sure, that displaces equal to volume, but a floating object, like a boat, displaces water equal to its weight. When they're full of water, those caissons weigh about 500 tons. You add 10 tons of floating boat to one of them, then 10 tons of water flows out into the canal, which means this is balanced no matter how much is actually floating in it.